These are railroad tracks. Railroad tracks are the best example of parallel lines. Lines on the same plane that will never touch are parallel lines. Parallel lines by themselves don't tell us a lot. However, if you cross them with other lines, things begin to happen. Here are two parallel lines cut by another line. The cutting line is called a transversal. When you cut two parallel lines by a transversal, the results are the formation of 8 angles. These 4 angles, 1, 2, 7, and 8, which are outside the parallel lines, are called, of course, external angles. And these 4, which are inside the parallel lines, are called internal angles. External angles, internal angles. Notice that the following 4 pairs of angles are vertical angles. 1 and 4, 2 and 3, 5 and 8, 6 and 7. Also that the following 4 pairs, because they are to either side of the transversal line, they are called alternate angles. 1 and 8, 2 and 7, 3 and 6, 4 and 5. And that the following 4 pairs of angles, because they face in the same direction, are called corresponding angles. 1 and 5, 2 and 6, 3 and 7, 4 and 8. Now, one sure thing can be said about each one of these pairs of angles previously mentioned. They are equal. In the first set, we can say that all pairs of vertical angles are equal. So 1 and 4 are equal. 2 and 3 are equal. 5 and 8 are equal. 6 and 7 are equal. Why? Remember chapter 2, section 2, when it was determined that all vertical angles are equal?